Yeah, Kim. The next question I have is, how does a PLM system help to manage the complexity of the product we just talked about, where the software drives electronics and mechanical components?
Well, the right PLM system has to do three things for you. The first one, it has to help you take your requirements, filter those requirements, and then split them up into the functions that you're going to implement. And the way you want to do this, the function describes what you want to achieve. It does not contain or detail how you're going to implement the function. You will do that later in the process. So that has to be supported by the tool. That's the first thing. The second thing is that the PLM system has to enable you to carry that function through your development process. So it has to provide you with a data model and a support where can all these different data from the electronic and software and mechanical domain are managed in one single entity, and that I can do my variants and configurations in a single way. So that's the second thing that the PLM system has to do to you. And the third thing is, you are not going to develop all these mechanical parts and electronics and the software in one single tool. You will have many, many design, engineering, and test tools that will be part of that process. So your PLM system better is able to talk to all of these tools and synchronize the data with all of these tools, because many engineers will be using a diversity of those. So your PLM system has to be open. It has to be built on open standard interfaces to be able to communicate with any tool, whether it's commercial or even homegrown, that you have in your chain, because otherwise you will detach certain pieces of your mechatronic process from your main PLM process. So openness is the third extremely important thing that the PLM system has to bring to the table here.